Secretariat under investigation. What am I supposed to do with that?
Maybe it's a different secretariat.
Oh, Jim from The Office.
Never watched it. Neither have I.
Okay. We get letters here on the show. This is from Bojack H. Bojack is 9 years old. Bojack writes, "Dear Secretariat, when I grow up, I want to be just like you, and I think I'm on the right track. Do you get it? Do you get my joke about the track?" Okay, there's a whole page of this.
Yes, now people know my reference.
Oh, no. I didn't realize it was from this.
"But sometimes I get sad. What do you do when you get sad? Oh. How do you not be sad? Sincerely, Bojack."
Bojack, when you get sad, you run. Straight ahead. Don't you stop running, and don't you ever look behind you. There's nothing for you behind you. All that exists is what's ahead.
No, I think it just goes to show you. You can be the fastest runner in the world, but you can't outrun the truth.
I'm taking a deep breath on this one.
Yeah.
You got to.
Looks like some idiot parked his car on the bridge.
Oh. Ugh. Wow, that's a start.
Yep.
Welcome to the finale of Sad Horse Man the Show.
I just noticed his, like, muzzle jiggles when he moves.
His muzzle jiggles.
Oh, it does!
It does! It jiggles!
I know what you mean. It's just funny.
I'm sorry. As an animation nerd, I can't help myself.
Enjoy away, kid. Enjoy away.
That muzzle don't jiggle jiggle.
It's this is a first win for Bojack Horseman and his first appearance at the Globe Ceremony since his forced removal in 1992 after he exchanged blows with Sir Paul McCartney.
Wow, what an honor.
This was before the slap.
Oh, wow!
Yep.
Also, my book was not a movie. You know, a lot of people said to me, "You sure you want to publish this book?
It's space."
And I said, "Fuck
you." I love him. Silly little himbo puppy.
Why did I say after party at my restaurant? I do not want to throw a party.
I forgot he has a restaurant.
Yep.
Elefante.
It's like a janky Olive Garden.
Oh, Elefino.
You want some?
No.
What the hell is he drinking?
Yes.
Hello, other grown-up.
Ugh. Oh, this guy.
Oh, no.
If you can't be happy tonight, maybe you'll never be happy again.
Princess Carolyn rocking that dress, can I just say?
I know, I was gonna say the same thing. I love her dress.
I was gonna say Princess Carolyn rocking his brain right now, because she just instilled a lot of sorrow into him.
Let's get away from the rat race. Take a cruise someplace wet and Latin.
This just proves that she wants to have somebody to take care of rather than...
Yep.
Have you met Brendan Fraser? I feel like you two would love each other.
Well, easy, easy.
Brendan Fraser? The man from The Mummy?
The Mummy.
Mr. Not Tarzan? Mr. George of the Jungle?
How is Diane? I haven't seen her since, Well, I haven't seen her in a while.
I just realized he's wearing a tuxedo. He's wearing the same tuxedo shirt he got married in.
Erica!
Erica!
Is that you? Who let you out of the burn ward?
Oh, no!
Burn ward?
I just have to tell you how much I love your book.
I'm a Zoe.
It's so naked and honest and revealing.
You want to get out of here?
What?
Come back to my place? Maybe get a little more naked, honest, and revealing?
Oh,
Oh, no.
No, thanks.
What about you?
Yeah, okay.
Oh, right, his bed's still broken.
Huh. Oh, I didn't realize she wrote that book.
Yeah, she wrote Secretariat's biography.
Oh, right.
Hello?
Diane!
Sebastian Sinclair!
Famed billionaire philanthropist adventurer. Please, hold your applause.
Everyone applause.
Yeah!
Looking for a journalist to follow me around for a few months and document my daring exploits aiding ravaged communities and displaced people.
People.
If you can make people care about Bojack Horseman, surely you can make them care about emaciated orphans with missing limbs. We need to wake people.
No! My brain goes to the armless, legless,
horrible.
Yeah, oh no. Droopy-faced children.
You know, droopy-eyed, armless children.
And sleep on the ground and poop in a bucket.
Honey, nobody wants to poop in a bucket.
Then poop in a bucket.
Yeah, if he gets to eat poop out of a bucket, then I get to eat poop out of a bucket.
No, that's not what they were talking about.
Well, if he gets to eat poop in a ball, I want to eat poop in a ball.
Can't you do all that in L.A.?
Oh, no.
But you're not going to find what you're looking for in these awful made-up places.
Made up?
What?
He's talking about Sudan.
I'm sorry?
The key to being happy isn't the search for meaning. It's to just keep yourself busy with unimportant nonsense. And eventually, you'll be dead.
Oh, God.
Oh.
You're not happy tied down, Diane.
No.
We're going through a rough patch. It's hard, you know. He works a full-time job at the business factory, so when he gets home, he just wants to unwind by watching R-rated movies.
The business factory?
Oh, are we talking about me again?
Oh, he's been carrying that around everywhere.
It's his only source of happiness.
I think now's the time to finally make Secretariat.
Really, now?
You asked me what I wanted to do, that's what I want. That's all I've ever wanted. And if I can't get it now, then all of this has been for nothing.
Ugh.
Why would you ever make things easy for me when instead you could make things incredibly difficult?
Incredibly difficult.
Incredibly difficult.
I have to push a boulder up a hill and then have it roll over me time and time again with no regard for my well-being.
Atta girl.
Oh.
Well, I got a stack of great scripts here. Any one of them would make a wonderful movie.
I love that they never mentioned it, but in the last episode, he was reading those scripts.
Ugh, Jesus, Todd, read louder much.
Oh, yeah.
He was screening them, yep.
A store where people can buy Halloween stuff. How come you never see a Halloween store in January?
That's my question, Todd.
I knew it.
A Halloween store that's open year-round.
No, just January.
Brilliant.
Oh my gosh.
So, what do you want to play, like Secretariat's dad or his grandfather? Mm. Maybe like an elderly witch doctor?
Elderly witch doctor?
Don't play the ageism card with me, kid. I've laid farts that lasted longer than your entire career. But Secretariat was dead at 27, so who are we kidding here?
Just set the project up and give me an audition. That's all I ask.
I'll make some phone calls and see what I can do. And by kid, I mean middle-aged adult.
Thank you for the clarification.
Has this ever happened to you?
What's going on? Why are you talking like that?
Why are you in my house?
But I want satisfaction now.
Has this ever happened to you?
Yes. As a cosplayer, yes.
Honestly, why not just relabel it the costume store? Like, yeah.
Honestly, yeah.
Guys, I think we've got a great idea.
We actually have a cosplay store in my town, or did at one point.
Never mind, someone already did it. Let's give up.
There's more suicides in January than any other month. Also, there's less Halloween stores. Coincidence?
Wait, I'm sorry?
You stop encouraging him, and you stop encouraging him.
I just saw the pie chart.
The two of you are playing with fire.
A fire called having a good idea.
Or maybe a fire called friendship.
That's what we're calling. We're renaming the channel. Fire called friendship.
Oh, no.
Can I be the fire?
You are the fire.
Heck yeah! Bird!
Giraffe! Business,
oh.
Is that all you ever think of? No, Vincent. There's more to being an adult than just work and business and the tall person rides at Disneyland. I want to have fun.
Oh my gosh.
You have games on your phone?
I really appreciate you giving me this opportunity.
Yeah.
Secretariat was kind of my hero as a kid.
Yeah, he was a lot of people's hero.
Just do the audition, buddy.
Be nice. She's just cranky because she's already seen 30 people read for this today, and we are all so goddamn sick of seeing auditions. So, yeah, whenever you're ready, just jump right in.
God damn it.
They think they recognize something in me, and I want to be that person that they think I am, but I'm not. They see a greatness in me, and they mistake it for goodness, but I know there's nothing there. As fast as I run, I can't get away from that.
Oh.
Wow. BoJack. I think I speak for everyone when I
say...
Oh,
my God. Andrew Garfield said yes.
No!
We got Andrew Garfield?
Oh, my God. It's the best day of my life.
You don't say no to Spider-Man.
You don't say no to Spider-Man.
Andrew Garfield!
That joke is so good. It's on, like...
Also, just applause for Will Arnett, because, wow. Oh, that voice acting is... Ugh.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Hold on. A mosquito got into my tent. What do you want?
Oh, that's right. Animal jokes.
Hello?
Diane, it's Princess Carolyn, BoJack's agent.
Yeah, I know who you are.
I'm the pink cat.
How is she pink, by the way?
Great question.
Don't question it.
We've met a lot of times. You came to my wedding.
Does she dye her hair?
That's a great question.
And since you're such an expert, they want to bring you on board as a character consultant.
Does she take a dye bath?
She's pink. She has great taste. That's all I'll say.
It's the cushiest job in the world. You sit in a fancy chair and eat pastries all day.
I think there's some bias there.
No. I don't have pink hair. What are you talking about?
If you really want to help people, it doesn't hurt to have a little money in your pocket. Take the job now. Help the orphans later.
There's always later.
Name of the episode, roll credits.
I gotta go get my whiskers trimmed. I run into walls for days, but I look hot.
She's getting her horn.
Painting her horn. I
can't. Screw it. Throw it in a bowl with some bourbon and bring me a ladle.
Mm-hmm.
A cow would work at a diner.
Oh, that joke still haunts me.
Another one? What happened to your Halloween store?
We took the floor out.
Halloween? In January?
Oh,
what
no.
A great idea.
Well, they've got skeletons.
Anyway, now we're all about smoothies.
What?
It's a mood that you drink like a smoothie.
This is just Bath and Body Works candles.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
It's their whole fragrance section.
You're right.
A day on the beach.
How do you drink a mood?
Like a smoothie.
And we want you to get in on the ground floor.
See, that's the problem with all your ideas. They don't have ground floors.
Finally, a Halloween store for the rest of
us.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh no.
That is a double kill count on Todd and Mr. Peanut Butter.
Oh my gosh, I wonder about the kill count of the show.
Did you say smoothies or smoothies? Because we only make, which one do we make?
I like to think the smoothies make us.
Ah, I could tell by your tone that that was something smart. Todd, it is all happening.
Hooray.
And you know, I don't throw that word around lightly.
I like them together.
They're great. Their dynamic is everything. Like you and I, Marky.
All right, now we just got to make sure we focus and actually follow through on this. I'd feel awful if this great idea fell apart because we got distracted by something else.
I feel like I'm getting called out right and left.
What? Why?
Because I have that issue where I'm like, I have a really great concept and I flesh it out for a while. And then all of a sudden I'm like, I'm going to work on something else.
Same. It's so bad.
I think that's just ADHD.
I'm single again and I'm loving it. Let me repeat.
Princess Carolyn.
Oh.
Vincent, I've got half a mind.
No.
I've got half a mind.
What is happening?
But then I took a time out and I thought about what I did.
Sometimes
the biggest thing a man can do is tell the truth.
The immature, literal child has learned a lesson BoJack has not been able to internalize.
Mm-hmm. I love you.
What?
Oh, Vincent.
Oh my God. Just goes to show age isn't always a component of maturity.
BoJack, it's Kelsey Jannings. I got some news about Secretariat.
What's up?
Garfield's out.
He got into some sort of accident.
An All Hallows Eve store in January?
Oh, bother.
We gotta find a new lead. Studio wants to go young, but I was thinking we get someone a little more BoJack Horseman.
I love Kelsey Jannings. She's so...
Not gonna put up with any woe is me bullshit or diva histrionics.
Good.
I get enough of that from my ex-wife, along with newspaper clippings about gluten.
Sorry?
God, we get it, Marla. Gluten.
I can. I do.
Great. You got 1 month to get in shape. You need to lose 50 pounds and then gain back 20.
What?
You lose 50 pounds of fat, gain 20 of muscle.
Okay. I thought they were making a joke about... Never mind.
A certain Avenger.
Not big on parties, huh?
Nah, I never know what to do with my hands.
I think I just got cast in Secretariat.
That's amazing.
It's everything I ever wanted.
Yeah, you seem super jazzed.
What do I do now?
Well, that's the problem with life, right? Either you know what you want and then you don't get what you want, or you get what you want and then you don't know what you want.
Well, that's stupid.
Yeah.
Well, do you think I'm a good person? Deep down?
That's the thing. I don't think I believe in deep down. I kind of think all you are is just the things that you do.
Yeah.
Well, that's depressing.
A little bit.
I was gonna say the same.
For what it's worth, I think your writing does make a difference.
Thanks.
I really wanted you to like me, Diane.
I know.
How the traffic. Ah!
Heartfelt moment. Kit. Traffic triggered!
Sorry we didn't get you a birthday present.
And I got so swept up in my campaign for class president, I forgot why I was running again. In the first place.
And I was boy crazy.
Thanks, Mabel.
Mabel.
Grappling hook.
I got everything I need right here.
Macaroni.
Sabrina.
Grappling hook.
Come here, you goofball.
Then Herb Kazaz, yeah.
The sun rises. And he goes back to the one place he's supposed to get a high five.
Can you make it out to Blake?
Uh-huh.
Thanks, man. You're like my hero.
Really? Huh.
Aww.
That one dog, bro.
Yeah, the dog talking. I love chocolate. I mean, I know it could kill me, but...
I like know.
Chocolate? I know.
Oh, that's it.
Let's not play the song because it's copyright. Blurring out the song because it's copyright. We're just dancing even though it's copyright.
Box reverses Raptor. No, 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 no.
Well, you did it, kid. That's season one.
I did it. I survived.
You did it. Thoughts, Kit, on first season?
It's a lot of pressure.
that's my thoughts. I really enjoy Futurama, but I don't enjoy things like The Simpsons or Family Guy or any of that, so I was really put off by this. However, the reason this show was so successful is, one, it's brilliantly written. Like, not only is it really, really funny, but, like, it has a lot to say. It's just, it's very poignant in a lot of places that I didn't expect from a show like this, to be perfectly frank with you. And I am actually really enjoying it, so I'm excited for season two.
Yay!
Yay!
Yay! Sorry, I'm human and I can't make fun little faces like that easily.
You can make funny faces. You are a funny face.
Have you ever heard of an actor called Jim Carrey? He makes funny faces all the time.
Segway, this is one of those stories you can only tell through animation. Like, if this is a live action show with people, I don't think it would hit as hard.
No.
Yeah.
You're right. They do really good at balance, though, too. Like, with the jokes and the humor, but also the dark stuff. I don't feel like I'm overwhelmed to the point that I just want to go lay down for the next 2 hours.
Oh, wait till season three.
Oh, great. Yeah.
There's a lot of thought that goes into why important characters are what they are and like what that represents for them. And I love that. I love just the deep storytelling hidden behind this haha funny cartoon for funny animals.
Yeah, if it didn't have that deeper part, I would have watched this once and moved on. Like, I could think of two episodes of Rick and Morty that I've rewatched. That's it. Aside from that,
yeah, Rick and Morty.
Like, yeah.
Moving on. It was fun. Interesting, but moving on.
Moving right along.
Oh, God. Moving right
along. Footloose and Fancy Free. BoJack Horseman's kind of like a burger, or it's like trying to make itself look like junk food, but it's actually got like vitamins in it somewhere.
It's a gourmet burger, Marky.
It's
like
gourmet,
one of those super fancy ones.
I was
ones.
Thinking it's like a bean burger or something that's supposed to be healthier for you, and like you think it's healthier for you.
Marky, what is this analogy you're going with?
No, I've got it. You think it's a hamburger made by Neptune, but actually it's made by SpongeBob. It's nice. It's special. They care about it. It's amazing.
I just watched that episode.
Crisp lettuce like, and the crunchy pickles.
A week ago.
Glad we're watching this now because actually BoJack hits its 10-year anniversary this year on August 22nd.
Wow.
And if you cried at the end of season one, comment down below. Tell us what your feelings are. You know, dissect away. Have fun.
Subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video.
Well, my name is Rob.
Yeah, that is your name.
Just say your name.
And I'm... Hang on. Oh, no. And I'm Kit.
I'm a duck.
Did you want more? Because you can watch the rest of BoJack here. Or a video that we've recently posted. I mean, if you're still around because you enjoy our company, you can click this button, too. Oh, yeah. It's a good button. Look at it. Oh, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.